Okay, atelectasis. Atelectasis is an important complication to understand about your patients because many of them can develop this after surgery or if they have excessive pulmonary secretions. So what is atelectasis? Atelectasis is a collapse of the lung. If you view here on this x-ray, the right lung here you can see is much smaller than the left lung. So this would be the area of atelectasis right here where you can see all this white space. So what happens is the alveoli deflate. What can happen is if the patient has excessive pulmonary secretions or if there's any sort of damage to that area or obstruction, things like that, that can cause these alveoli to actually deflate. And as those little teeny tiny alveoli deflate, this area of lung becomes deflated, okay, or collapses. It's very common after surgery, okay, so keep that in mind. Some of the assessment findings you're going to find are obviously diminished breath sounds on affected side. The patient may develop a fever. They're going to have chest pain. As they're breathing, it's going to cause excessive amounts of pain for them on that collapsed side. This is going to be very painful for them as they're trying to draw air into here because of this collapsed area. And then obviously chest x-ray is going to show the area of collapse. Okay, so this is all that area of collapse, and that's going to be our atelectasis. Okay, so treatment, CPT. So this is chest physical therapy. So what happens with the CPT is they wrap a little, well, okay, let's say here's our patient. They'll wrap a little band around here that will deliver vibrations from a machine, and that's going to loosen up those secretions. IPPB, IPPB, what that is you've probably seen this before. The patient will take, so they'll be hooked up to this little machine. Well, they'll be able to breathe in through here, this little machine here, where they can have, it means intermittent positive pressure breathing. So they're going to have medications and inhalers and things that can be hooked up onto here, and they'll basically just do this intermittently, 4 hours or so. This will deliver a little bit of extra air for them. It's going to cause that positive pressure into there and hopefully inflate the lung again. Incentive spirometer, deep breathing. It's important to teach the patient about what the incentive spirometer is, how to use it, that they need to inhale very deeply for 10 seconds or so and then exhale. And they're trying to beat their last achievement. So they're trying to breathe in as deep as they can, take in as much volume as they can, and that's going to help expand those lungs again. And then position changes, of course, to help them be able to move the lungs around and help with the pain and things like that. All right, so that's what atelectasis is. That's how it's going to be treated. And these are some things that you're going to definitely see. CPT, physical therapy of the chest. IPPB, delivering that intermittent positive pressure breathing. It's not ventilation. It's not anything like that, but it's just going to be something they can actually put in their mouth and breathe in, and then incentive spirometry. All right, guys, that is atelectasis, and have a great day. Thank you.